Hi, welcome to KTV5 video tutorial. Another remake of the crankcase, the Kurbelgehäuse in Katia, because I did this in Katia as well almost 5 years ago. So let's have fun with KTV5. Okay, let's start with a sketch on the YZ plane. Hide as usual the yellow projected elements. I need a circle. And diameter should be 38. That point should be on that axis, coincident, and on the other one as well. Leave that sketch, make an extrude, and make it with mirrored extent, and that would be 33.5. Sorry, come on, 33.5 divided by 2. Next sketch, same plane, hide, now rectangle, and I don't want those constraints. Parallel to H and V. So this would be 8, and that distance should be 38. That distance would be 19, and this should be a symmetry line. Now let's insert that in a new body. So go for a new body. Move this over here. Make an extrude in two directions, and one direction would be this 16.75, and the other one would be 6.75, but minus. And okay. Now let's make a pattern with that body, the current solid. Reference direction would be that axis. Reverse distance should be 23.5. And of course, second direction is this one. Again, two instances, and the distance should be 20, 30, 30. Yeah. Now I could unite those bodies, so go for add, this one to that one, and okay. Oh, sorry, I forgot. First I want to make a fillet, so just make this pad the object which is in work and make a 3-tangent fillet. Don't know what it is happening. I wanted to do a 3-tangent fillet. Okay, first side, second side, this should be removed. Okay, and again, this face, that face, and this would be removed. And okay, now make this the body which is in work, and okay. Now the sketch on that plane right here, hide those elements as usual. Another circle, diameter should be 32. That point should be on this axis and on the other axis as well. Close this one, make another extrude, and distance would be 67.5. Okay, next sketch on this plane, hide those. Another rectangle, delete those constraints. If you wonder why I delete these constraints, take a look at my CATIA V5 basic videos. There is everything explained. This distance should be 6, and that distance should be 16, and this should be symmetric to that axis, and this one and that axis are coincident. Another extrude, mirrored, 16.75. okay, now sketch right there again, hide, circle, that circle should have a diameter of 43, and that point should be coincident to both axis. Okay, now you could do that sketch on a plane which you create over here, up here, of course. So go for another pad, that distance would be 67.5, and the second one would be minus 66, because that's 1.5, so that should do the trick. Yeah, now let's make a rectangular pattern with that feature here, and I need 8 instances. Distance should be 3 millimeter, direction would be the set, no sorry, that axis right here, and I can't get a grip on it, so that would be the Z axis, not the current solid but that pad. Reverse direction and confirm. Nice. Now the sketch, now on the Z axis plane, hide, a rectangle, delete those constraints, and this should be that's 38 plus 11, that's 49. Is it 38 plus 11? Yeah, it's 49. That distance should be 11. And those two should be symmetric to that axis right here. And the distance from that axis up to that line is 41 minus 5.5. 41 minus 5.5. Okay. Now let's make a pad with that sketch in the other direction, and distance is 26. So I want this to be in a new body, so you could do it like this and insert it in a new body. Then make it the object which is in work, active. Now I could do again a tri-tangent and fillet, face, okay. And repeat, face, remove that face, and okay. It's assembled, but I don't want to use add and assemble, I don't want to mix it, so I will delete this one and add that body to the main body, the part body. So this one should be added to the part body, that's okay. Now make this the active body. I need a sketch on the XY plane. Maybe I go for a positioned one, so I have more control how this works out. So I want to swap and reverse V, okay, hide those. Now I need a circle and a rectangle. So first the circle and the rectangle, and as usual to get those parallel constraints. So that would be 43, should be coincident on both axes. This should be symmetric to that axis. Distance should be 26. This should be coincident, and then I can trim. That's okay, yes. Then make an extrude with that sketch and this should be in a new body, so I will do it as before. That distance would be 44. So put this in a new body. deleted the sample. Make it the active body and make the fillets. This time it's an edge fillet, 5 millimeter, yes, on that edge and this edge. Okay, and another one up here. Okay, then add this one to that one. So go for body 4 and add, and it's done. You don't have to do it with multiple bodies, you can do it in one body as well. So that's almost all the material I need up there. So I could go for a plane, or I could draw a circle right here and move it with an offset up. I think in NX I did a plane, so I will insert a plane. Doesn't matter, it's for free. So the distance would be 67.5, and yeah, that's okay. Now let's do a sketch on that top plane right here. Hide those, and that would be a circle. Diameter would be 8, I suppose, no, 7. This should be coincident on that axis, and this distance should be 17. Yeah. Leave that sketch, make an extrude, reverse direction, and distance should be 8. Now I need a circular pattern, so I want to pattern that pad. Go for circular pattern. I need a complete crown, 6 instances. Complete crown means it's 360 degrees, and that should be the axis. And usually you want to keep specifications. In this case it doesn't matter, but usually you should keep specifications. Okay, that's all the material I need. So I will copy that sketch, copy, paste, and change the diameter. And diameter would be 32. Leave that sketch and make a pocket. Make it symmetric, mirror extend, and that would be 16.75. Nice. Then this one, I copy that sketch, copy, paste it right here. Go to that sketch, change the diameter from 32 to 27. Leave that sketch, make another pocket, turn it around, make it, no, that's the wrong button, reverse direction of course, and it should go up to last. Okay, now I want to reuse that sketch right here. I think that's this sketch. Copy, paste. Yeah. Go to that sketch and change this value to, that's only 8. This should be 26, and that distance should be 41 minus 4. Leave that sketch, make another pocket, make it up to last, yes, and okay. Next will be not that one, but I need this sketch right here. Copy, paste, go to that sketch, change the values. So that diameter should be 40, and this one should be 23. Leave that sketch. And now I will make this here a body, a new body. So yeah, make a block with that sketch, and that distance should be 44 minus 1.5. And the second direction, should be minus 6. Okay, this should go into a new body. Delete that assemble. There's my body, make it the active body and hide the other bodies, so let's show only the active body. Where's my switch? There it is. And there should be fillets 3.5 on this edge and that edge. Okay, and one more on this edge. Okay, now I want to subtract that body from the part body. So go for subtract, remove this body right here from the part body, from this one, and okay, nice. Now all the holes are missing. You can do this up here with a hole or with a pocket. I might do it with a pocket because I have already the sketch. That would be the sketch. Copy that sketch, paste it right here. Go into that sketch, change. No, that's the wrong one, sorry. This happened, so I will delete it. Rectangular pattern, yes, circular pattern. This one should be the right sketch. Copy, paste. Yeah, that's it. And that diameter should be 3. Okay. Now let's make a pocket in that direction, but not up to last, with a distance, and that distance should be 5. Now let's head on this complete crown. Reference element would be the set axis and keep specifications. Okay. Then select that edge right here, go for hole, select the face, make it 3, depth would be 3 as well. Okay, now you could do it with a rectangular or a circular pattern, so I go for a circular pattern, that's more convenient. Another complete crown, 4 instances, reference element would be that axis, and I want to pattern that hole. Okay, now I can mirror that hole and those holes because I have no thread. So I want to mirror the hole and the pattern. Go for mirror. So that can't be mirrored. That's great. Really? Okay. So let's do another hole. Doesn't matter. And another circular pattern. So select the edge, then the hole feature, then the face, and your whole sketch will be already ISO constrained. 3-3, that's okay. Confirm. Select it, make a circular pattern. Complete crown, 4 instances around that axis, and keep specifications. Okay. Very nice. Now let's go. Edge, whole face. Now it's 3, but it's up to last. And okay, you could mirror it, or I can just do another one, or you could make a pattern. I do another one on that face, same values, and okay. Now missing all those, therefore I will need a position sketch, or I could go for a reference point, whatever you like. So I go for a point, and that point would have the following coordinates. Let's take a look. It's, make this locked. Y is 27.5, and X should be 12.5. Okay, now I got a point, and with that point I should be able, where is my point? It's invisible. Really? That point should be visible right here. How come? Let's take a look if my point is correct. Yeah, there it is. And it should be visible. It's not visible, that's crazy. Okay, anyway, I can do a hole with that point on that surface, and that would be 3 mm up to the next, and okay. Now I need a rectangular pattern. Well, that hole should be patterned. as usual, keep specifications. Y would be one direction, and you don't need two instances. Reverse it, and the distance would be 40, 55, and the second direction would be that axis right here, and the distance would be 25. But this should be reversed, and okay, and I'm done. So hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like. If you want to see more, please give it a like. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please, please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page, and please, please like it. Would be very nice of you. So thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.